Good morning, everybody. John Swift here. There were some birds just a second ago that were chirping.
But they decided. There they are.
Are those... Hello. There you go.
Are those seagulls? They look like seagulls, because I'm out near the water here.
But I never heard a seagull make that noise before. Normally it's more like a... Not that sound. Getting louder. So today I'm on this little nature trail that cuts between University of South Florida and the neighborhood that's right to the south of it. It's called the Bayfront Trail. It's not a really long area, but it's a very peaceful area on a real quiet neighborhood. And I got somebody a golf cart down here. It's in a peaceful area of Sarasota where there's a lot of seagulls that like to go. A lot of golf carts apparently come through here from the schools, I guess, back and forth. So just kind of having a ADD morning. There goes my man on the golf cart. Having a little bit of an ADD where I was having a lot of thoughts. You ever have that where you're having a lot of thoughts going through your head in the morning when you wake up? Sometimes it gets to the point where you're sort of drives you crazy because you can't focus on stuff. You can't focus on like what you want to do and what you're currently doing. That wasn't the purpose of the vlog, but I just thought I would mention that in case I'm having a bad vlog day and you wonder what the heck's going on with me. So I didn't make a list like I did on Friday of stuff to talk about, but I did try to nail down some things. When I got up this morning, I was thinking about maybe I should talk about when I had a back injury and the struggle that I had with that. And I still struggle a little bit with the pain and stuff. And sometimes I wake up in the morning and I just feel compelled to do a vlog about something, like the day I did the depression one about depression. Just sort of something compels me to just say you should really talk about that, because sharing your story, I think, gives others strength. I think like when you have a support group about something, about cancer or about diabetes or something like that that people struggle with, having a support group where you can relate to people your struggles somehow makes you feel a little bit better about it. And so, as well as wanting to have a lot of fun vlogs where we're out exploring stuff and checking out abandoned houses and stuff, I also want to put in some personal stuff because I feel that sort of makes us grow a little closer. I tell you some personal stuff about me, tend to bond over that, and hopefully at some point you guys will start commenting and I can learn about you guys too. That would be fun to have a comment. And if you want to comment on this video, feel free to comment with your experience. Over the weekend, I met with a friend of mine who's going through some struggles with health issues and stuff, and I can see that it's been really tough on him the last couple years with different things that's been going on. And I'm sure everybody knows somebody who has went through some physical issues or a car accident or some kind of debilitating injury, whether it's a broken leg or heart attack or something. Seems like almost, most of us end up going in one part of our life, we end up going through something that takes a lot to get over. My grandfather is about the only person that I never heard had an illness. He lived to be 103. I never saw him sick one day in his life. It's really interesting that way. And I think toward the end he had a stroke and he had some issues when he was probably over 100 at that point. Some physical issues. Good morning.
Hi.
And so he actually wrote like a mini biography, an autobiography about his life. The only time I ever heard him going to the hospital was when he got shot in World War I. That's how old he was. He was in World War I. It was something like 1915 or 1916. That is as long ago as that sounds. He got shot in the buttock and the rear buttock and the buttock. And he ended up going to a medical hospital in Europe, I think. And then he knew how to play piano, so he stayed there because people like having him around, because he would play the piano and entertain people. But I never heard of him ever staying in the hospital, as long as he was, besides right at the very end, but I'm saying into his 80s and 90s. But most of us, anyway, getting a little off track, most of us have had an injury or an illness or something. I say most of us, and not all of us. So the one thing I wanted to relate to you guys is a back injury that I had in 2014. Some squirrels jumping around over there.
Right over there.
My back wasn't in the greatest shape in the first place. Usually when I would go out and play tennis, I would always have a sore back afterward. And occasionally when I would do something, like I would stoop too low to get a shot, I'd feel something kind of twinge in my back. And then that day, I'd usually sit home for the rest, like if it was a Saturday, I would sit home for the rest of the day and take a bunch of Tylenol and rest. And the next day it would be sore, and it usually be for a couple days it'd be sore. And you know, by next week I would be okay. And there was a couple times where I picked up something too heavy and I would tweak it. It's always the right, lower right side. I think it was the, what do they call that? It's that, morning. That's okay. It's the bundle of nerves at your bottom of your back, down here in the middle of your back, that I used to tweak. It was always, yeah, that right side of my back would always get tweaked, depending on if I was out shoveling or something or trying to do something. And it's like one of those things, a lot of people have bad backs and you just kind of have to just bear with it. I mean, just do nothing or bear, you know, just go out and try to do your normal thing and take Tylenol and, you know, you go to your doctor if it's something serious or whatever. But so in November, I was playing a game of tennis and I remember going to the net and I was, I did a real sudden move to get a volley or something, and I just, it was like I was going left and then I reached right and I tweaked it, and immediately like took the breath out of me. And I think it was the last game and we took a break, and I was trying to stretch it out, but it was like a bungee cord, like a muscle was tightening in there. It was just tight, like somebody had a tightener. It was just tightening that muscle, my back, and it was just getting really bad and I could barely move. It was like if I just turned to the right, it was really tight. And I was like, okay, I really tweaked it this time. So I had to tell, I think we'd already played two sets, we were sort of at the end of our sets, and I told him I can't play anymore, I don't think so, because I'm just too tight. Usually I would have gritted it out through the pain anyway. But I got home, I went to bed, it immediately tightened up to where it was like I could almost not move. My girlfriend got home later that day. I told her I think I really hurt my back because I can barely move. And I was trying to get up to go to the bathroom. I was just basically sitting in bed, you know, I had a drink, watching TV, took a whole bunch of Tylenol, so hope that would help. And I was so stiff I could barely move, and to get up to go to the bathroom, it was like I had to like push myself up real, you know, these people that have had back, I couldn't actually use my muscles on my back to get up. So I was like, I was rolling over and sliding off the bed, and I actually had a cane that I was using to get, it was a real short trip to the bathroom. But anyway, it was super painful. And I soon realized it wasn't the norm, because the next day it hurt really bad too. And I didn't have health insurance at the time, so I wasn't really eager to go run to the hospital and go to the doctor, because I've been to the doctor 1,000 times, and if you've been to the doctor for pain or an injury, they say, here's some pain pills. Normally they would say, here's some pain pills, go get the prescription filled, take a couple, you know, rest for a week and you should be okay. Or, you know, if it doesn't feel better, isn't this what they always say? If it doesn't feel better, come back and pay me some more money. So I've had this back problem, so I was just being optimistic and just wait and see. Well, I think 3 or 4 days later, it was starting to feel a little bit better, but still tight. And I actually didn't go to work for that week. And I went down to see my cat or something, and my back tweaked, and I immediately just frozen. Like, you see, have you ever seen a movie where somebody bends over and they freeze and they can't move? Well, basically, I just crumbled onto the ground like a baby. I crumbled onto the ground. It was probably some of the most intense pain that I've ever experienced in my life. Everything tightened up. If I just moved an inch, it hurt. So I was calling to my girlfriend that I hurt my back, and she came out and she's like, "What's the problem?" I said, "I tweaked my back. I don't know what happened. I just bent over and it hurt." It scared the hell out of me. I was thinking I was going to have to call 911 and get an ambulance and have them take me to the hospital and go on traction. I was like, I got really scared. So after a while, I just laid flat on the living room floor where I fell. Well, not where I laid down. And I asked my girlfriend to get me some water and a pillow, and she had to go to work like right after that. So she left me there. It doesn't sound that good, but she left me there because she had to go to work. I wasn't in dire illness, I just couldn't really move much. So I turned the TV on. I sat, it was right by my dresser. It was like right a couple feet away from the TV. I just laid on the ground, I think with my knees up with a pillow, and just was hoping that the pain would go away. And I think she gave me some ibuprofen or something, and I took about 4 ibuprofen. It was frightening. I have never experienced that kind of immobilization with an injury in my life. It's pretty frightening. If you ever had that happen to you, you know, when you can't move because the pain is so excruciating. Like, if somebody would have picked me up, and I would have been screaming, literally screaming with pain. So I think about after 3 hours of laying on the floor, I rolled over. I kept testing it. I kept moving, but if I moved an inch, like, this pain would just shoot through my body. So anyway, after a couple hours, it started to go away a little bit. I think the medicine started working, and I got up and I crawled to my bedroom on all fours, and I crawled up on my bed. Boy, I was, you know, with that kind of pain where you're out of breath because, like, so the pain is so excruciating, you're sort of going, you're holding your breath because you're afraid you're gonna die from the pain. So I ended up crawling into bed, like literally pulling myself, because I was afraid to use my back to pick myself up because it hurt so bad. And I finally got into bed, and I was rolling myself into position. I got into bed, and as long as I didn't move, I was okay. But as soon as I tried to move to do something, so I think I stayed there for about 5 hours. I didn't go to the bathroom because it was terrifying, the thought of getting up and going. And I was thinking, should I just call 911 and just go to the hospital? I was sort of in doubt, you know, what they were going to do, if I was going to have to be, like, in a hospital bed, you know, on one of those flat boards. They've ever seen somebody in traction? I have in a movie where they sort of have you on a rotating table. It's got bands, and you're like, kind of strapped into it, and they can rotate you so you don't get, like, bed sores, and they rotate you so you circulate. I was so scared. It was one of the most scariest things that I had in my life. I didn't want to sit in the hospital. Like I said, I didn't have insurance, so that was another issue. So that time passed. But ever since then, and I think that was right before Christmas when I sort of retweaked it, bending down. Right before Thanksgiving. And my sister was planning on it, and I had tweaked it the day before Thanksgiving. Okay, it was Thanksgiving, it wasn't Christmas. The day before Thanksgiving, I tweaked it where I couldn't move, and my sister, I had to call her and tell her, I don't know if I'm going to be able to sit in a chair. Like, I'm in bed. I've been in bed for 24 hours. So she wanted to come down anyway and see me. So I did my best to sit on the couch, but it was like, I couldn't sit anywhere, but like at a certain angle, like I had to have my back, you know, I couldn't sit back like this. I was in so much pain. I was taking extra strength Tylenol too. I was taking two, like, they're basically equivalent, what extra strength Excedrin is, where it has two Tylenol, two aspirin, and two things of, like, doses of caffeine, which is pretty strong. And I think I might have had some leftover pain pills, but even that wasn't knocking out the pain. I mean, it turned out it was like a nerve pain thing. It was a pinched nerve or something. What do they call that? The sacrum or something? The very bottom of your spine down there was getting pinched. And so I ended up missing a lot of work. I couldn't work with my girlfriend. I was very lucky at that time that I could take the time off, and I wasn't, it wasn't an issue. It was very scary though. Very scary time in my life. I've had foot injuries and leg injuries and surgery on my foot, and I've had shoulder injuries, but nothing is more debilitating physically and being able to be mobile more than a back, because if you break your leg, you can get up on crutches and you can go somewhere. If you break your arm, you're in a cast, you have one of those little slings and you can go somewhere. You know, if you do anything to your neck or your back, you're pretty much done. Or you're like your ribs, that's always a bad one. If you break your ribs, you can't hardly function because your torso. So I have been through that, and I just kind of wanted to talk a little bit about getting through that. So after a couple weeks later, it started to heal, but I would still have constant back pain. I could move, but it was still like constant lower back pain. So I ended up going to the acupuncturist for $40 and getting some acupuncture, because somebody recommended that to me, that more than just taking pain pills, you know, to go to an acupuncturist. And I was doing, she recommended some stretching, so I was doing some yoga stretching, the kind where you get on the ground, you tuck your knees under your stomach, and you reach out with both hands and you stretch your lower back. So I was doing that too, which didn't seem to help at the time, immediately after. Then I got another job in December. And here's the thing that I wanted to mention. There's the important part of the story. I wasn't up and about a lot. I think I might have tried walking. We walked a little bit, say a couple weeks after, to try to get back into the rhythm. I was jogging before I got this back. I was jogging and playing tennis. And when I got that, when I injured my back playing tennis, then I stopped jogging immediately, of course. But I think I started walking after a couple weeks. You know, walking outside, not just walking, walking as exercise, you know, walk a couple miles.
The helicopter over there, little red helicopter.
Always makes me wonder why what they're doing when they have a helicopter. So, where are we at? We're at 16 minutes, so we're doing pretty good. There's an emergency pull station if we have an emergency right there. All right, so I got a job at Target for extra Christmas money that year, 2014. I was working with my girlfriend, I was doing my YouTube stuff, and I wanted to, I needed some extra Christmas money, so I worked temporarily at Target. The funny thing is, when I worked at Target, being up for a couple hours, like 4 or 6 hours, actually helped my back improve. So I guess it was strengthening it, because like a sort of an isometric thing maybe, where I was just standing, and sometimes I was kneeling, just that exercise was strengthening my back. Because if you've ever been to rehab, you know what they basically do is, like, if you had a leg injury, they will strengthen your leg back to the way it was. They will try to do, you know, you do exercises. Like in the case of my shoulder, I had a shoulder tear. They had me do certain kind of exercises which would strengthen the muscles around the shoulder injury, that way overall strengthening that weak part, making it feel better. And it did, a lot of those, most of those things helped. So actually, because like I said, I wasn't purposely going, I wasn't playing tennis anymore, that was out. But I was going out and just, you know, working at Target, walking and standing and things like that. And at the end of the day, I would feel better. Like I would take like a Tylenol. Some days I would take like an extra strength Tylenol and I'd go to work and it would feel better, actually. Better than if I actually rested that day. Like I was doing a lot of video editing at that time. Like I was keeping busy with editing video and I was putting a lot of pictures on Facebook and doing busy work like that kind of stuff to keep busy when I couldn't get up and about and it was too painful. You know, I put a lot of old videos on back then. I was transferring a lot of VHS, but that's neither here nor there. But anyway, it gave me something to do while I was almost bedridden. So that exercise, just working over the Christmas, you know, over December, actually made my, I thought the stress was going to make my back. So that's the lesson I learned from having this injury, is to get out. You think, you know, walking would be the worst thing for my back. It's the opposite. Getting out, walking, being mobile, gets your blood flowing, gets those muscles loosened up, and actually helps you. And, you know, my back was very weak after a couple weeks of being, for the most part, bedridden or just staying in bed. So that's the message I kind of want to put out. I also want to ask you guys, what do you think of these vlogs where we're just sort of talking about life experience and stuff? Because I like to do the fun vlogs too. And when I'm out doing stuff or seeing a beautiful sunset or out looking at the water with the birds or doing those fun kind of things, are these, you know, leave a comment of what you think. Or is this a mixture of, you know, fun stuff and talks? What do you think of that sort of mixture? Because it sort of breaks it up a little. For me, it breaks it up a little bit. And I, like I said, I do feel compelled to help other people through my life experience, if I can help somebody by just sharing my personal experience of struggles and, you know, depression stuff and all kinds of physical stuff that I've had to overcome over the years. Does that help? Does that, are these kind of vlogs, do you enjoy these vlogs? That's what I want to know. So, because I want to sort of focus on the areas where people, you know, what people like to watch in my videos. That's about all I can say about that. Just I try to listen to the responses I get and sort of tailor this somewhat. Because this vlog isn't just about me, it's about you guys too, because you guys are here too. So I will continue to do the fun vlogs, the goofy vlogs, the weather vlogs, the news vlogs, like over the weekend. I think the last one was the tornado house. What did you think of that one? Leave a comment if you liked that one. That was a little bit more serious news because it wasn't a fun, I don't believe that's cool to make fun of a subject like that. Even though that's kind of where my personality is just kind of making fun of, like even my own back injury, I make fun of stuff like that. You know, my own foot injury, I try to make light of it because it's you know, I can't take everything seriously. I'm serious about some things, but a lot of things it helps me get through life. So yeah, I shot a couple vlogs over the weekend I wanted to talk about. If you have any questions about the back thing or anything like that, leave me a. If you have a question, you know, get a hold of me on social morning. Get a hold of me on social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, that kind of stuff. So my back's feeling pretty good today. A little stiff, but I did my yoga stretching in the morning and it's a lot better. Yeah, the stretching really, really helps if you have any kind of back injury or any kind of spinal neck injury. Stretching is definitely the way to go. I did take a bunch of ibuprofen though, just in case, so that helps. So anyway, over the weekend, I went out to shoot a abandoned property where there was a house out there, and I will be hopefully uploading that in the next 2 days. That was pretty cool. It was a big property down south. Lots of wooded, dense trees and trails, and there was a couple little things I found out in the woods that are interesting. Because it had, at one time, you could see on the map, it had a lot of roads, dirt roads, but the couple years since that Google map was taken, it's actually grown over, so I was like doing the jungle gym thing where I was like going through this dense, you know, vines and jungle area to try and find this abandoned property that I saw on Google. It worked out pretty good. I was a little apprehensive at first, but it sort of worked itself out. I was a little nervous to go out there. I was afraid I was going to get caught by somebody, but it sort of worked out. And I also, I was sort of driving around that property to see if I could get. I was trying to get out to the water. There was this bridge I saw on the map, and I thought it'd be cool if I could go find that bridge. It would be something interesting to see. There was a couple little lagoons there, and the bridge went over a lagoon. It was really interesting. I still didn't find the bridge, but I will probably go back at one point with my GPS map and check that out. So then after I got out of there, I was driving around and I saw this church, and I was looking on the map to find out more about like how you get around, what is on the other side of that property. And I ran into a wildlife preserve that was interesting. And on that preserve, there's actually a preserve area where you can't, you're not supposed to walk, where they actually have eagle nesting there. So I got some video of an eagle, two eagles and their two babies. It was very far away, and I have a limited zoom capability in this camera, but that was pretty interesting, so I'll be uploading that this week too, hopefully. Some footage of that eagle hanging out on the top of a real tall tree, and also I found a little, well, I won't say. I'll just tease that. I found a little something else in their video, so check that one out. And I actually saw three vlogs, and then what else did I do? Oh, the tornado house. On the way out there, I was thinking, tornado house is right on the way, so I wanted to see this house that had been damaged, heavily damaged. The whole second floor was collapsed. So I actually did those three vlogs in one day. I uploaded the tornado house already. Today is going to be a wonderful day, despite my ADD issues. Today is going to be awesome. I'm really trying to be positive. I want to say hi to my friend Mikey if he's watching. Hey Mikey, how you doing? I'm just feeling really positive about this week. I'm feeling positive. I got a lot of good videos to shoot. I got to edit. I'm not feeling positive about editing because I hate editing, but we'll push through that and I'll. I like the videos like this where I don't have to edit as much. But anyway, let me know what you thought of this video. It was awesome having you guys with me. this video, this vlog would not be anything if you guys weren't watching. So I appreciate you being here. Check me out on my social media. Have a great week, guys. I'm gonna go jog and stimulate my physical and mental senses. We'll see you in the next vlog. Have a great week, guys. Bye-bye.